Now, we're going to be talking about something, depending on who you are, depends how you feel. They say people feel a certain way when you're directly involved. When it's directly in your backyard, when it's directly in your vicinity or whatever you want to call it, then that's when you get a little worried or upset or concerned. So there are these buses of full of people from different countries that have been getting shipped to the city of Chicago. Now, originally, they're saying they all come through the border towns, which is Texas, for example, and they are just overly crowded. So they put them on buses and they send them to different places across the country. The state of Illinois, the city of Chicago, we are a safe haven for anybody that wants to come. And we begin some buses and we begin some people. And just here, like here at WinnieCityUnderground.com, when I leave here, we are located in the downtown area. When I leave here and I'm driving back home, I see them all in the street. And they're out there in force. At first I was like, this is strange. I've never seen this before in downtown. But then it made sense. Oh, that's why. So we're gonna be getting to the story. This comes to you from Fox 32 Chicago. Chicago provides $9,000 in residential assistance to migrants seeking temporary housing. This week, 41 buses have arrived in Chicago, bringing the total of number of immigrants in shelters to 11,000, with 4,000 still sleeping on police station floors and staying at airports. That's a lot of people. Notably, 30% of migrants in Chicago are children, with the majority of them attending CPS or Chicago Public Schools. Currently, the state is funding temporary housing, including rented apartments and homes for migrants. The state is providing up to $9,000 in residential assistance over a six-month period, which includes assistance with moving in and a starter kit to furnish the apartment. That rent lasts for 6 months, and ideally people would have started their legal process, secured legal work authorization, and may be able to sustain their apartment. And so the cost, or I guess the payment towards the landlord, is based on the market rate. It's based on the configuration of the payment, how many rooms, where is it located, all those things. And so it varies from place to place, said Alderman Zayas. Fox 32 reached out to inquire about the number of asylum seekers utilizing the residential assistance, but as of now, there has been no response to the city. The city has allocated $4 million to assist migrants in obtaining temporary housing, with the state contributing an additional $38 million. At present, 30 to 40 CEAS management workers from the Catholic Charities are actively working to secure temporary housing for those thousands of immigrants, with efforts underway to hire more. So how do you feel about it? 41 buses just this week. They're saying 11,000 in shelters, with 4,000 of them sleeping on the floor. Some people are concerned. I did mention the weather coming in. It's a little chilly. It's getting cold. Winter's coming. Imagine sleeping on a floor. I don't care if it's heated inside, the floor is still cold. You're sleeping on the floor. A lot of them children, a lot of them at police stations, a lot of them at airports. And I've been seeing a lot of tents lately. And they're saying that a lot of people are sitting at these tents all over the city. And some people don't like that. They don't like the fact that they're setting up right next to them. They don't like the fact that the state or the city is giving them money. They're saying, you know, we still have homeless here. Why can't you take care of the homeless here like that? Well, that's a good question. That's a good question. $9,000 in residential assistance to help them with furniture, to help them get their legal status up, to help them with all that stuff. And then at the end of that 6 months, what's going to happen? That's where it gets interesting. Do they extend that program? Are some of them going to be able to continue to rent that apartment? Are they going to be able to get themselves situated here? Do we have that many jobs here in the city of Chicago? Or do they go elsewhere? I mean, what do you do? It's no matter how you shape it or word it, whatever, everybody's going to have an opinion. Now, I don't know how to feel about it. I feel for them, honestly. They're coming from some countries that are really bad. And they're, like, for example, one country in particular, a lot of people from Venezuela are coming to the United States. They're asylum seekers. Venezuela is not pro-America. They have, I guess, like a dictatorship out there, kind of, sort of. And it's, from what I hear, it's bad out there. It's bad. But then you come to the United States looking for a better opportunity. Then they sent him to Chicago. Now, Chicago's a beautiful place. Beautiful place, right? They say it's one of the best cities in the world. We'll talk to you, Google that. But Chicago also is a dangerous place. So you're bringing all these people into these areas that are not very friendly. And yeah, things happen. So I don't know. I look at the children, man. The children, they can't help it. They're going there with their parents. They're probably terrified. They're going to a place they don't know. They don't know the language, different culture, different everything. And there they are sleeping on floors. For how long have they been doing that? In airports. I feel for the kids. And I come from a family of immigrants. There's an old story that my mom told me. How true is it? I don't know, but this is a story they told me way back when, early. My dad, rest in peace, I think he came here in maybe 30s or 40s, 1930s, 40s, something like that. And the story goes, he came to this country on a train, underneath the train, not on the train, underneath the train. He had to sneak in underneath a train. And the train stopped in Nevada. And when he got off of that train, he was covered, if you can imagine, in dirt, dust, coal, whatever. It's a dirty road, right? Underneath that train. And he comes out, and he's covered like in dirt. And this American family saw him and was like, oh my God. They saw him, showed compassion, cleaned him up, gave him a meal, helped him set up. Fast forward, before he passed, this immigrant was able to become a homeowner, to put his kids through college. Not me, but my sisters. Put them through college. And, really lived out that American dream. Worked every day, almost. He was always working to provide for his family. He lived out that American dream. Now imagine that same story. He gets off of the train, he's covered in dirt. That American family, instead of showing compassion, would have told him, hey, insulted him, threatened him, whatever. Didn't give him a shot. Would he have still had that story? I don't know. We are all human beings. This is what I'm trying to say. We are all human beings. And we should all show that kind of compassion. I know it might be uncomfortable. It might be affecting us at this moment. I get it. It sucks, right? I wish it was a perfect world, and I wish there was a better answer that I can give you. I wish they didn't have to come here. I wish the country that they were originally from was just as great, you know, and they had opportunities there to grow and to prosper, all that stuff. But unfortunately, that's not the world we live in. That's not the world we live in. So they come to this country looking for a better opportunity. And some people are giving it to them, some people are not. What do you do? Now, Lord forbid, they say, hey, you know what? You can come here, but we have no money for you. Sorry, you're going to have to figure it out. Here comes winter. They're all sleeping in tents on the floor of these police stations, on the floor of the airports. And Lord forbid, they say, what, 30% were kids? Right? Let's just say a small portion of them pass away due to cold. Then to freezing to death or whatever. They didn't have enough food. Then people are going to be like, hey, why didn't you do anything to help them out? You could have did something to help them out. You can't win. Everybody's always going to have their side, their opinion. And it's a trip, man. It's a tough spot. If you are not only the governor, what if you are the mayor? You know, Mayor Brandon Johnson. Check this out. This story comes for you from ABC7. Delegations to Chicago's leader heading to the southern border this week without Mayor Brandon Johnson. So they are going to the south of the border to maybe discuss it. Let's quickly read the story. A delegation of local leaders will head to the southern border this weekend without Mayor Brandon Johnson, his office said on Monday. Johnson administration is coordinating a small delegation of city, state, faith, other leaders led by Deputy Mayor of Immigration, Migrants and Refugee Rights, Beatrice Ponce de Leon, to visit the southern border this week beginning Tuesday. The mayor, along with senior aides and key operational personnel, will stay in Chicago to address the immediate urgency of aiding shelter space to house thousands of new arrivals, his office said. The delegation will travel to El Paso, San Antonio, McAllen, and Bronzeville which Johnson's office said comprise of the primary points of departure for migrants traveling from Texas to Chicago by bus and plane. Johnson's office said the purpose of the trip is to review operations, processing centers, and multiple and NGO-led transit sites and speak with local stakeholders about ways to alleviate the financial aid and operation challenges in Chicago and at the border. The delegation will seek to establish better lines of communication to collect migrant data to expedite work authorization processing, the mayor's office said. The delegation will also share information about extreme housing and weather conditions that asylum seekers face. The delegation will brief the mayor and other leaders when they return to Chicago, Johnson's office said. They will be a follow-up trip. So Mayor Brandon Johnson, brand new mayor, just got elected. This is a big one. How does he handle this? How does he handle it? I heard somewhere, I don't have the story in front of me, but I did see like a town hall. There were some people from other communities expressing their opinion on the matter. They were mad. They were very passionate. They were mad. They were very mad about all these immigrants coming into the city in their neighborhoods. They're getting all this money. They're getting all this attention. And they're saying their communities need it too. That money that was promised to the south and to the west side. How come they don't get that money? How come the immigrants get that money? Do you agree or disagree? She's speaking out for her community. It was a woman that was saying it. She was speaking out for her community, and I could feel her pain. At the same time, I look at it, the immigrants too, man. It sucks. But what do you do? They're coming here, asylum seekers. They're looking for something. You know, a roof over their head, food in their stomachs, clothes on their backs. They have kids. They're trying to give them that American dream. Again, I go back to my dad. You know, somebody showed compassion for him, helped him when he first got here. And he was able to live that American dream. But I get it, man. I mean, a lot of people are complaining. You know, everything's expensive these days, man. We don't have money for it. Why don't we invest that money in ourselves? We have homeless here. We have areas in the city of Chicago that really need these resources. What is being done to help us out? We've been here for how long? And we've been asking for help. And here come these immigrants and you give them everything. I get that argument too. I get it too. I'm glad I'm not mayor. I don't have the answer. I don't have the answer to that. He's trying to do the best he can. I get it. That's a tough cookie. That's a tough pill to swallow. So they're at least they're going to the border. They're trying to figure it out. They're trying to see, okay, look, you're going to send us people. You're going to send us buses. We need to figure out where we're going to house them, what kind of funding we're going to get to take care of them, because our budget's already needed all over the place, all over the city needs something. So I can see why people are upset.